dream I know. Deep up my feelings for you. Watch them grow. Perceive deep.
Ong Seung-woo, Shin Chae-yoon-woo, and ASCI revealed to be the highest earners for Fantagio. On March 29, Fantagio Entertainment released a securities report that showed that ASCIO, Ong Seung-woo, and ASDIO's Shin Chae-yoon-woo were their highest earners. According to the report, Ong Seung-woo brought in a total of 7.308 billion won, about $6.45 million, in profits from 2018 to 2020, while Shin Chae-yoon-woo brought in a total of 6.458 billion won, about $5.7 million. Ong Seung-woo, who made his debut in the project Group 101, achieved sales records of 1.44 billion won and about $1.271 million in 2018, 3.125 billion won and about $2.76 million in 2019, and 3.043 billion won and about $2.685 million in 2020. In 2020, he released his first solo album Layers and took on his first rom-com role in the JEBC drama, More Than Friends. Shin Chae-yoon-woo achieved sales records of 1.378 billion won, about $1.216 million in 2018, 2.504 billion won and about $2.21 million in 2019. And 2.576 billion won and about $2.273 million in 2020. He made his official debut with ASCIO in 2016, and has been active as an actor for several years, appearing in at least one project per year. He made waves with his role in the TVN drama, True Beauty, in 2020, and is currently a fixed member on the SBS variety show, Master in the House. Fantagio's greatest source of revenue is ASCIO, who achieved sales records of 4.116 billion won in 2018, 6.423 billion won in 2019, and 6.314 billion won in 2020. In 2020, ASCIO made up 38% of the agency's sales revenue. According to the securities report, the ASCIO members' contract will last until February 2023, while Ong Seung-woo's goes until August 2024. Fantagio's girl group Wakimeki's contract is set to last until August 2024 as well. The report also stated that there are currently 50 artists and trainees signed under exclusive contracts with the agency, with about 31 of those artists having currently debuted. There are no artists whose contracts are set to expire within a year of the report's release.